This YCN segment is brought to you by Harris Family Furniture in Plymouth, Laconia, and Chichester.
Welcome back. YCN Sports Talk. Jeremy Stout, Rob Taylor in studio, and we talk some Celtics. I know it's been a week since the loss in Game 5. Don't want to bring up the painful memories, but we got to talk about it a little bit. We talked about it last week with Brett Franklin. We didn't think they'd give much effort, and they certainly didn't. They kind of limped to the finish line, and a lackluster performance, not much of a fight, losing in 5 games to the Bucks. I know Milwaukee was the better team, but you would have liked to see a little bit more of a fight.
Absolutely. I was hoping for a much better series, but it certainly seemed to just kind of fizzle. Put up a great performance in Game 1, and then that team sort of went on vacation, and I don't know whatever became of them.
Right.
And so, yeah, there's a little sadness and disappointment. We had talked about this on some shows previously. Would we be disappointed if they
right.
didn't make it to at least the conference finals?
Yeah.
So, I'm going to put it on a sort of the list of disappointments for the season, and just cross our fingers with perhaps some good news in the off season, which we can talk about.
Yeah, I mean, that's the next question. The offseason, obviously, like you said, started a little sooner than we had hoped, but that's the big question in everybody's mind. Obviously, the draft lottery on Tuesday night, we'll get to that as it plays in the whole NBA. Obviously, some surprising news there. But for the Celtics, Kyrie Irving, does he come back? Terry Rozier, is he the starting point guard next year? And what is the long-term plan for this team? We'll just open the floor up, and where do we start?
Trying to read the tea leaves is what the NBA is all about. If I'm a betting man, I'm going to say Kyrie is not a Celtic next year. I think he sort of started to hint around that he's ready to go. Obviously, we have to wait through the draft. I think it's June 20th, and then the trading starts after July 1. See what happens there. But I'm going to say that Kyrie is in a different uniform next year.
Right, yeah, I agree with you.
And things are going to change. Now, here's the question. Do we have any luck in this Anthony Davis game? I think, he goes to one of three teams, either the Celtics, the Knicks, or the Lakers. And, of course, the whole thing about the draft, we had the
lottery.
Ping pong ball thing last night.
Yeah.
And it's much more about sort of the pick than the actual person.
Right.
So what do we do with our pick? How do we sort of form a package deal? Celtics have some other picks in the draft. They can sort of package up for some kind of a trade, some kind of a deal with another team. And perhaps it is with the Pelicans to try to get Anthony Davis. Of course, the fact that the Pelicans got the
right, no, that kind of throws a wrench into everything. But if Kyrie doesn't come back, do they have a good enough team with Tatum, Brown? We saw Rozier play as a starting point guard last year when Irving was hurt. Could they kind of tread water a little bit until they get maybe a free agent opportunity? Or maybe it's Kevin Durant, maybe it's Klay Thompson. Or is this kind of team kind of stuck in limbo right now? They don't have a superstar, but they're not bad.
Yeah. The way that the Bucks kind of ate him up in the series really left me seriously concerned. They just really had no answer for the big man, Giannis. And you watch some of the highlights of those four wins that the Bucks put on him. I mean, they were just getting owned by him in the middle. He was just having his way. And I mean, he is a force of nature.
Right.
So, I mean, that seems to be one of the things they got to address is some power in the middle. Maybe some kind of a big man to try to help plug up those holes. But, man, if they could get somebody like Anthony Davis,
that
would be huge.
Yeah.
And I think, Danny Ainge has said he's not willing to give up on Kyrie. So it's going to be an interesting offseason for the Cs, no doubt about it.
And I think a lot of people were thinking Kyrie might go to the Knicks if they get the number one pick. And like you said, Anthony Davis might get traded. But as you alluded to, the draft lottery last night, a couple surprises. So we'll talk about that next. So the number one pick going to New Orleans. The Knicks not really getting a high draft pick. Plus, we'll get some NBA playoff talk as well. We'll take a break. You're watching YCN Sports Talk.